in words unclean. As I began to write this tribute about my friend, my colleague, and my sister, these same words ignited my spirit. As I reflected on the influence, the impact that Rowena had on my life, it became clear why these words lingered with me. You see, Madam, as we affectionately called each other, was a wonderful example of God's hand in the earth. She liked the word of God. She bore witness to God's truth through her actions. Her contagious smile and soft but firm spoken words always assured us novice teachers that we could conquer the world. As administrator, she was among the best. She demonstrated excellence and demanded the same. Madam Fawkes was a role model. Which she was not willing to do because of her positive disposition toward this profession. I learned that teaching is more than a job, it's a vocation. Rowena Sylvia Fawkes was indeed a valuable asset to hundreds of teachers and thousands of students. She gave stellar and committed service to the Department of Education and by extension the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. Hard work and diligence was not all she did. She had an enjoyable presence. This was firstly revealed to me when I called her permission to go to the pantry to purchase some lunch. However, when I returned, she commented on how much food I had purchased. Long story short, after that, every trip I made to the pantry was to purchase lunch for Madam and I. Our joke about our eating was never seen. Sorry, our joke about this never seen was it that the food I ate never seemed to do the job. This tickled her pink, and I allowed her to have fun with it every time she saw me. Madam, as we called each other, was a woman of integrity. She demonstrated positive personal values in all she did and said. She was sincere and real. Instead of giving you a false verdict on a situation, she preferred to remain quiet. This was indeed admirable. Everything she did and said was a true reflection of what she valued. She valued her relationship with God. She talked of being salt and light and dear. She valued her testimony and lived it up. As we began, our positive feelings just developed for each other as close friends. She reinforced values and built reputation and self-esteem in many of her colleagues. Bloomed. As a teacher under her administration, she would not support you if it was something that was negative. It was useless looking her way if you were insubordinate to the higher person. This was indeed an admirable quality, and she respected I respected her for it, as she respected others. Her where she used words to hurt others. That got me thinking one time. Wow, I said. Once you're in conversation with my thoughts, you're going to leave safe. She recognized that there is power in the tongue, and what you give to the world is difficult to take back. She made the most of every moment. Madam Fawkes utilized her time wisely. Whenever I spoke with her, she had either just completed some activity or was bound to participate in another. She focused on the now instead of later. She was prudent with her time. She knew that God had loaned her to us for a time, and so she made sure her commitment to fulfill her life's work was accomplished. When I reflected on all she did, I simply repented and made a commitment to utilize my time more wisely. As I began, I end. Madam Fawkes was truly a woman of God, a woman of virtue. She accepted God's love, walked in love, and was lovable. Madam walked in faith and not by sight. She lived on the premise that no weapon formed against her will prosper. She knew that God had chosen her, and she used her gifts and talents to make a positive impact in the lives of so many. She impacted my life greatly. My friend, my colleague, my sister, Madam Rowena Fawkes, was truly an example of the believer in word and in deed. I thank God for her life. May her soul rest in peace.